killed this man. Oh my God. They done killed this man. Oh my God, he got to be dead now.
Government is critical to keeping the government in its place. But while government loves keeping an eye on us, it hates it when we keep an eye on it. And it's been easier to do so. It makes it more dangerous. More and more citizens are recording their interactions with the police using simple and perfectly legal devices like their cell phones. And the cops don't like that one bit, increasingly resisting the tapings with force and even jail time.
Now there's probably someone who's going to be around with a cell phone camera to take a video and post it on YouTube. And really, I mean, transparency is, I think, half the battle.
This little thing is a weapon against tyranny.
Simon Glick, a Boston lawyer, was arrested in 2007 for using his cell phone video camera to record a man who was being beaten by Boston cops. Bystanders were heard shouting, "You're hurting him!" Glick never interfered or obstructed the police in any way. He was 10 feet away, nearly recorded what was occurring in open view before the world.
They work for us, and we deserve to know what they're doing. To that end, police in particular, you know this, we just saw it, have been known to trample the constitutional rights of people all the time. What you have a right to know is that you absolutely can video and audio tape them. The police routinely violate the Constitution when they pull over your car or stop you on the street. They ask you intrusive questions that you don't have to answer. They sometimes even rough people up. They push them off their bicycles. They threaten them with guns. They basically treat you like you're guilty of a crime before you've even been charged or convicted of one. The Constitution protects you from this type of police behavior. And many Americans have realized that policemen, often not caring about the Constitution, need to be photographed. So courageous Americans have decided to video and audio tape their interactions with law enforcement as a way to protect themselves from police mistreatment or to prove what happened. Yet big government is so afraid of people recording the police, it tries to ban the practice. This is completely unconstitutional. The First Amendment guarantees our right to free speech. That includes the right to listen to and record what happens in public. Cameras and recording devices are simply modern-day note-taking. And if people are using them to keep the police honest, to tell the truth about law enforcement abusing rights, then it is the right of the people to record these affronts to the Constitution. For the government to record us is Orwell's 1984 come true. For us to record the government is a public right and a smart thing to do.
The whole world is watching!